Thank you, Sami. Mr. J.K. Dadu, Additional Secretary and Financial Advisor, Ministry of Commerce. Mr. Porish Singh, Divisional President, MasterCards. Mr. Abhijit Tana, Chief Technology Officer, and friends, good afternoon to all of you. So Samir has asked me to speak on the security aspects of the digital cash. But what struck to me that my name is the last. So first you set up the infrastructure and then invite the security guy to look at the security aspects. Though I am grateful to him that he is inviting him in the same panel, this is the way we are looking at the structure of security in the country. First, set up the infrastructure, the way my friend Samir has set up all people from morning to evening, I mean, full session, they all spoke Digital India. Of course, some of them might have spoken on the security also. And the last, me and Mr. Tanna, we are in the security aspect. Friends, we have been talking about the national infrastructure, that internet is critical to the national infrastructure. All we have been talking about it. But today, this is the de facto position that the internet and ICT is a critical and vital component of any transaction, of any infrastructure, our economy, national security, financial systems, all what all we talk about it. The last 14 to 15 years, what we have seen, there has been a paradigm shift. Security has never been so important, which has become, and still we need to realize how do we implement security, how the security has become important. We are implementing all kinds of technologies. We talk about the WWW. We talk about the social media. We talk about the mobile technology. We talk about the virtual kind of clouds there. And we talk about the IoT also. These all the technology development has come the last 10 years. IoT is now starting coming on the scene. But we are implementing these technologies in every sector and predominantly in the financial sector. My friend Porush Singh will certainly tell you what kind of things they have done in the, they are the one of the largest organizations spread out worldwide in the area of a digital cash. Not from today, for years together. They are pioneers of that. So when these technologies have been implemented, of course, my earlier speakers talk about Digital India or talk about things. But the question which I asked, the point which I asked, which I said started, do we integrate security at the time of planning the infrastructure? Do we integrate that? Or like my friend Sameen, okay, security guy is also there, let him come in the last. That issue becomes important in today's world. I don't know how many of you have noticed. IoT has come on this scene, maybe in our country now, but in other countries couple of years ago, 2-3 years ago. But 1/3 of the western coast of US was shut down in October because someone hacked a baby monitor of a fisher and then went into the entire internet, and 1/3 of the western coast was shut down. Of course, the financial institutions are also were there. We have seen similar impact when the media brought out the news of 3.2 million card. I don't know how they bring out the compromise there, but what a kind of havoc it created in the minds of the people. It has shaken many people. And I was talking to a few of my colleagues day before yesterday, And still they feel, people who are dealing with the security or the technology development, they still feel that we will not deal with the transactions, particularly financial, on the internet. This really, I mean, can we avoid? I ask him, we can't avoid for a longer period. We need to deal with this. But then puts a question, thought, that we really need to implement the security on the internet. Internet was never designed to be a secure medium. It's a complete open system there. There are a few characteristics which we need to understand about internet from the other communication. In a general mobile communication, because we are marrying the two technologies, the mobile communication or any communication, the government licenses the service provider, they set up the infrastructure, and it is used, that said infrastructure is used by the public, set up by the private, used by the public. But in the internet, the infrastructure is set up in the public and used by the private. Just opposite concept. And the two need to be married together, and the two are marrying together. So there are challenges. How do we implement? And we need to design a model and architecture which marry the two. Public-private, private-public. These two models just opposite, and we need to marry together. It's a unique thing which in India is also there. My friend Mr. Singh will bear with me out. The entire financial sector, I don't know how much is the MasterCard, is outsourced, work on an outsourced model. The equipments are, some of the equipment is owned by the organizations, institutions, and some of the equipment is hired, outsourced, and money is paid based on the transaction. Any bank is following, any financial institution is following this model. In fact, at the end of the day, if the bank has to draw a end of the statement, what transactions have happened, they tell the outsource vendor, draw the statement and give it to me. All passwords are open. All passwords are with everyone. The critical systems, the passwords, the infrastructure is with the outsource vendor. And not one vendor, there are multiple vendors are working, and there is no coordination among those vendors. This all, the architecture part which is prevailing here. That's why I was saying, at the time of planning the infrastructure, we never planned what kind of a architecture we need to do so that we can implement it. Does it happen when we set up a building, civil building? This building must have been, while at the time of designing, we must have planned where, what are the security thing we need to implement, where are the doors we need to do that, how would the size of the door, how the size of the window, everything is done in the planning, but why we are not able to do at the IT implementation. There is a serious problem. There are serious vulnerabilities, and we need to work together. There are five principles, because I don't want to take much time with you. I will come straight on the point. We need to follow the guidelines. We need to follow the understanding among ourselves. It's the government, industry, users. We need to follow certain guidelines. And the number one is the shared responsibility. All of us have a shared responsibility. If my debit card, I swipe it, if it is compromised, my card is compromised, whole thing will get compromised. So I need to ensure that I keep the security of my card intact. I don't share my passwords. The banks keep on sending a message, you don't disclose this, don't do that. So we need to see that our PIN number, our everything should be secure. That's responsibility of a user who is the owner and who is the holder of the card. The second one is the infrastructure owner, the outsource vendor who is complete. He has to make sure that the entire infrastructure is secured. Now, how to make secure? I will come on that. Third is the financial institutions who's running that infrastructure. They have a responsibility. And fourth is the government is also a holder because they have to facilitate by virtue of policy, making legal framework other. So there is a shared responsibility among all of them which we need to do that. Each one of can contribute. And of course, we are working with the MasterCard and Visa card and the RuPay and other financial institutions. We lay down the exact, the broader best practices for each of these stakeholders which are involved in the entire digital cash. When the incident happened with the large amount withdrawal in one of the banks in the country, we have been working with the SWIFT and we are coming forward with those guidelines along with the SWIFT and the Indian Banks Association, which the banks need to follow for a transaction on the SWIFT. It's said to be one of the very secure kind of a network, but it's under the tremendous attack. They are improved their security. So it's each one of them we need to work together in a shared responsibility and come back to the what all needs to be done by which stakeholder and need to be practiced. Because I mean it becomes very difficult to find out who is the actual culprit who has breached the entire system or one system, but how they breach it. Partnership. The second is the partnership which we need to deal with together. The public, private, there has to be a partnership. In a partnership model, the financial institution when outsource the entire infrastructure, that will happen, that will never go away, whatever it may happen. Even the MasterCard, which they operate big infrastructure, not only in this country, outside the country, I'm sure they must have also outsourced large part of their operation to someone else. So this partnership, they need to have shared the responsibility in terms of toward the customer, toward the subscriber, when they do the digital cash. And they have to implement security. How the security is to be implemented? You need to have a proper service level agreement. And the service level agreement, in my view, apart from saying 99% uptime, this uptime, it should be that my infrastructure should remain secure. Any malicious activity of 1, 2, 3 happen, we need to work it out. It is their responsibility. Their responsibility. Maybe in this process, maybe new entrepreneur model will come out. But that's where the partnership has to come between the industry which is operating those infrastructure. The third part is the education or the capacity development. And that's where it becomes important. How did it happen? Whatever the media brought out, the cards, the so-called debit card or the credit card, which when news was come out, in some branch somebody put a skimmer. The guard who was there or who was not there, he didn't notice. Nobody noticed that somebody is going to put a cash. Nobody noticed. So we need to train people right from the beginning who puts a cash in the cage there in the ATM, who collects the things, checks from that particular machine, how the data is transferred, what kind of issues will come up in that. There is need to be capacity development. And then capacity development is not the government. Government has the educational institution, they will give a broader knowledge. But it's the industry, the service provider, they have to evolve because domain knowledge is with them. They have to evolve the particular model under which these various exigencies or various incidents can happen, and they need to train people, they train their own people how to handle those incidents. It's my experience that in institutions which has in-house team for handling the security breaches or emergency responses, they have done fairly well. Their outrage is much lesser than those institutions which have no capability or in-house kind of a capability. That's a capacity development has to come, maybe 3 weeks course, 2 weeks course, 1 week course. And it can be done with the education institution. And I'm ready to play my role, active role or dominant role, lead role if the industry wants to liaison between the industry as well as the educational institution to bridge some of the courses. But actually, these institutions, they need to set up a cell to educate, to train people, not only there, but some other also. And this is where I request my friend Mr. Singh, they need to take a lead the way SWIFT has taken a lead. I think Master, Visa and all those diners, they have also to take a lead to come out with the best practices. that training should provide to the people, because they, it's the, Mr. Dadu was mentioning when I entered here, 700 million card and all kind of figures he was providing it. 600 million cards belong to Master and Visa. 100 is the rupee. But nevertheless, three of them has to come forward and undertake the capacity development. Practices which you, and practice is far more important, process you follow far more important than what you implement the technology. Technology comes only 15-20%. And the last one is the international. Master has so much infrastructure in the country, they are authenticating here. Visa doesn't have any infrastructure in the country. Rupee has infrastructure, NFS in the country. Well, I'm not advocating that we need to put an infrastructure here because it's a global village. But then we must have arrangement. These companies must think of themselves as Indian, and they must be ready to share, work with the government to mitigate those incidents and work out to find out the root cause of those incidents. That is where the international cooperation has to come. Yes, I understand they have the, they are the company registered in their respective countries. They have obligation of the countries. They have to follow laws of the country. But we need to find some international kind of a thing where we need to work together, where they work with the government and they try to bring those kind of incidences together. Because digital cash goes like this: how to preserve evidence, how to collect the evidence, ultimately the quality and the integrity of the evidence, which will matter in mitigating the incidents, finding the culprit, and then taking to the final course in the law. All those things need to fund to do that, and we need to follow these guidelines if we need to procure, if we need to have to augment our digital cash, if to move the digital cash there. I think I have taken too much time. I wish, that's why I said I get more time. It's a very complex. I am not going to frighten you, but I can only tell you that situation is becoming more complex. The distinction between a terrorist, between a spy agency, between the state hacker or a novice, a professional like a hacker, is blurring, getting more and more blurred. Same guy can do many of those things here and there, and it becomes very, very difficult. Today morning itself, there was a news, one of the largest attack happened on Yahoo. They must have spent a lot of money. Many of things, what happens in the Google every day, they are not out, but lot many attacks are happening on the Google, on the Facebook, they also have. So in the situation is becoming quite challenging. More we move towards the technology implementation or sophistication, more we are becoming vulnerable, because the hackers also have the those technology available to them. They use this technology. That's where we need to be vigilant. We need to work together. And some of the things my friend, the CTO, who was earlier to me, he said those process practices we need to put in place there. Recording of the data, recording of the logs, we need to put in place. And I'm sure, I'm glad the MasterCard is present here. I certainly would like to use this forum or the opportunity to request him and his other organizations who are dealing with this, that they should come out and work with the government to create those structures which I have mentioned, so that we are able to assure the consumers that the digital transaction in digital cash is secure and much, much better and much tensionless than what we have in physical. Thank you very much, Samir, for giving me opportunity to say something